Got some more geometry problems for you. Geometry, come on, geometry, there's supposed to be a diagram. Ah, I guess we'll have to draw the diagram ourselves, you know, word problems. Turn the words into math. Geometry problems, we turn the words into a diagram. That's how we turn it into math. So we'll go ahead and turn this into math by drawing a diagram. Point X is on AB, so we'll start off, we'll draw AB. There's AB. Point X is on here such that the ratio of AX to XB is 1 to 4. That means AX is a lot smaller than XB, so X is closer to A than to B. All right, next sentence. Point B is the midpoint of segment AC. AC, there's, so I have to figure out where C is. If B is the midpoint of AC, then C's got to be way out there somewhere. And I know you can't see that. I can't hardly see it either, so this isn't really going to fit on my screen here. I mean, I could try to put it right there, but that doesn't really work because B is supposed to be in the midpoint of AC, and we want our diagrams to at least be close. So what are we going to do? Well, if you start off drawing a diagram and it's not going to fit on your piece of paper or on my screen, start over. Drawing these diagrams is easy. We can just start over again. Now that we've read the whole question, that's another way to avoid making a bad diagram, is read the whole question first. We know we're going to start off with segment AB. B is the midpoint of AC, so we're going to have to go farther past B. So if we started off with AB, we're going to have to keep on going to get all the way out to C. We start off with AB. B is the midpoint of AC. And now we have a diagram that fits on the screen. And we also know that point X is on AB, and is closer to A than it is to B. And we need to find the ratio of AX to AC. But we don't know any of these lengths. Actually, we don't even have all the information from the problem in our diagram. We don't actually have this information in our diagram yet. This AX to XB is 1 to 4. We have to capture the fact that whatever AX is, XB is 4 times as large. So if AX is 1, XB is 4. If AX is 3, XB is 12, whatever AX is, whatever AX is, we can use a variable that'll stand for whatever AX is. And that's how we can get this information into the diagram. If AX is S, we know the ratio of AX to XB is 1 to 4. That means BX is 4 times AX. It's 4S. And we know that B is the midpoint of AC, so we go on to this next sentence. AB has to equal BC. S plus 4S is 5S, so BC is also 5S. And look at our key strategy there. We're getting all this information into the diagram by assigning a variable. And going ahead and labeling our diagram, label the variable S to AX, and we label each of the other lengths as we find them. Now, we don't know what S is. We don't know what any of these lengths are. But we don't need to. We need to find AX over AC. And we know that AX is S. And we know that AC is S plus 4S plus 5S is 10S. So this ratio, this fraction, AX over AC is S over 10S. The S's cancel out. So no matter what S is, no matter what these lengths actually are, AX over AC is 1 over 10. And we're done with this problem. On to the next one. Yikes, it's a lot more words. All right, turn the words into math. The words go into a diagram first. Let's see, we got equilateral triangle PQR. PQR. Point S is on the opposite line, side of the line QR from point, which means S is up here somewhere. I don't want to draw a diagram over my question. I did it again. Read the whole question, Richard. Come on. All right, we'll start over. Diagram doesn't fit. Don't make a mess. Make a new diagram. All right, we know what we're going to do here. Read the whole question. Got equilateral triangle PQR. S is on the opposite side of QR from point P, such that the perimeter of QRS is 31. So if we start off with a triangle again, I'm going to label this one P, this Q, and this is R. So then I can put S over here somewhere. I don't really know where it is, but We'll just stick it out here somewhere. We'll call that S. And I want to find the perimeter of PQSR, the perimeter of this triangle. So I at least have the triangles up here, but I have a lot more information in this problem that's not in my diagram yet. Perimeter of equilateral triangle. Perimeter means the sum of the side lengths. That's all perimeter means is how long does it take you to walk around it, what the distance is walking around it. Equilateral, that means all three of these sides, each of them has the same length. All three are the same, and they add up to 24. There are three sides. 24 divided by 3, that means each of these has length 8. All right, so we've got that information. That first sentence now is now right here in the diagram. Now we're on to the next sentence. We got the perimeter of triangle QRS. That means we add these three sides, we get 31. Now if only we can find these other two side lengths, then we can get the perimeter we want. The whole thing, PQSR. I know that this is 8, but I don't know what these two are. I can put in variables for it, x and y. And what I do know is that x plus y plus 8, I know that x plus y plus 8 equals 31. So again, all I'm doing is turning all these words into a diagram, into equations we can handle. I know that x plus y plus 8 is 31 because the perimeter of QRS is 31. I can subtract 8 from both sides, and I get x plus y is 23. Now what? Well, I can't find x and y. Let's focus on what we're trying to find. It's one of the things I like to do in geometry problems is go backwards. When I'm stuck, I look at what I'm looking for and see if I can go backwards from there to get the answer. What I'm looking for here is, what is the perimeter of PQSR? The perimeter of PQSR is 8 plus x plus y plus 8. So that perimeter is 16, the 2 eighths, plus x plus y. And I know what x plus y is. X plus y is 23. Add 23 to 16 and we get 39. We didn't even have to figure out what x and y are. Is the key strategy there is keep your eye on the ball. Focus on what you're looking for. What is the perimeter of PQSR? And you might see that you already have it and you're done.